Would you please briefly describe your field?
So, the kinds of problems that I work on are basically of the following type. I try to prove rigorous mathematical theorems about general relativity, about black holes, about singularities inside of black holes, and what that means for unfortunate observers who fall into black holes. But of course, as mathematics, this is something which is in between partial differential equations, differential geometry, and of course has the spirit of mathematical physics, which is, if you want, the general domain of proving rigorously facts about the sort of physical world.
Okay. Among the many theorems you've proven, which one is your favorite?
Well, it's a difficult question, but I'd have to say that maybe my favorite theorem is some joint work I did with Jonathan Luke a few years ago about the stability of what are known as Cauchy horizons inside black holes. There are somehow two reasons why I like this theorem. One of it is just that it's really something about the fundamental nature of the problem of determinism in nature, in physics, and it's really remarkable that the problem of determinism boils down to something that goes on inside of black holes. So I like this philosophical aspect. I'm not sure what my position is, whether nature being deterministic is a good or bad thing, but nonetheless, it's something I like to think about. But another reason I like this theorem, and okay, I say it's my favorite theorem, is that it's something that really I started to think about already in my thesis. But in my thesis, I could only do sort of a toy model of this problem, where a lot of symmetry was assumed.
Mm-hmm.
And at that time, if you had told me that, you know, one day one would be able to think about this problem seriously in the absence of such symmetry, I would have thought that's great. But things moved very, very rapidly in the sort of intervening years, and I had a very, very good collaborator from whom I learned a lot from, Jonathan Luke. So, but that connection is maybe one of the reasons why, for me, that problem is very personal.
Is there a result in your field that you think every mathematician should be aware of?
Well, I don't know if I would single out a single result. I think one nice thing about this field is that not just mathematicians, but it's a field that the general public can enjoy. And believe me, if you work in this field, very, very often you're asked about black holes and sort of, you know, many, many people will ask. In fact, and sometimes the questions are quite thought-provoking. But on the mathematical side, I think what is very nice is that for whatever reason, maybe it's just also a matter of this period, it is a domain where mathematics can say surprising things, unexpected things rigorously. I mean, for instance, this result I mentioned earlier today of Christoph Kehle and Ryan Unger disproving the third law of black hole thermodynamics. That's an example of such a statement. It's surprising. And it's actually, I think, the fact that mathematics is rigorous and definitive that allows it to say surprising things, things that change the narrative on, you know, issues that we've thought of for many years somehow in black hole physics. Mathematics can actually change the narrative. So that's an example. But I think there are many very, very nice results in recent years that say fundamental things about these objects. And I wouldn't want to choose it.
Okay, thanks. Where do you think the field is going?
Well, that's also a very good question. Certainly, this is a field where at the level of technology, it's become much more sophisticated in the last 20 years. So when I started working questions in this domain, sort of the the technology was much less advanced. Of course, okay, that made it easier on the one hand. On the other hand, there was much less you could do. And I think the game has been upped in recent years. There's been huge sort of technical advances. And so the scope of problems that one could solve has greatly been enlarged. And if you want me to say something more specific, maybe I'll say the following. But so I think in recent years, we've been in an era where one has been able to prove stability results for non-trivial solutions without symmetry. These results, quite technical, I think in reality, they could probably be done with much less sort of complication. Mm-hmm. But in any case, that's sort of where, to a large extent, the frontier has been up to now. But I can hope for a future where we really study problems which are beyond stability problems, problems that, you know, very, very interesting, unstable behavior occurs without assuming any symmetry, without assuming anything like that, and yet we can understand that mathematically. So I think that is the direction of travel. I think in your generation, there certainly will be a lot of progress in that domain. So that's really, I think, where the field is going, and you know, I look forward to seeing that.
Is there an example of such a problem?
Well, I mean, I think we're sort of, you know, it's the usual thing that in order to get there, you need a gateway. Mm-hmm. I think one of several gateways is looking in a neighborhood of extremal black holes. The reason that it can be thought of as a gateway between, you know, from stability to instability is precisely that it has some features of stability problems, but also there are known instabilities. And so it's a very good test case for, you know, can we still understand completely the dynamics in the presence of instabilities? And so I think that is an example, but it's only the first example of, there are open conjectures, as you probably know, in the subject about the nature of generic singularities in, let's say, for the vacuum equations. If you are to believe these conjectures, they say that the situation is very, very complicated. So you might say mathematics is never going to be able to rigorously understand this picture, but I'm optimistic. I think it will. And that's certainly the at least in the very long term, that is one of the main goals of this area.
Okay. Maybe in line with the previous question, is there something you'd like to see proven in the next 10 years in our field?
Well, I'd certainly like to see what I mentioned earlier today, of course, in the talk, and I just mentioned here, namely, I would like to see the full dynamics of, let's say, the vacuum equations, but even, you know, in the context of this problem, you know, a model problem would be very nice. It's a fairly symmetric charge scalar field, full dynamics, near extremality, completely understood. I think this is a wonderful window of the phase space of solutions to the action equations, where mathematics can say something new, something people did not expect, and it's a very subtle. The full story there is very subtle. There's a lot of complication, and I think it will be very beautiful. And I think it can be done in the next 10 years.
Perfect. Thank you so much for the interview.
Thanks for having me here. It was a wonderful visit to Münster, and it was very nice meeting so many young mathematicians here, including me.